Welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Francis Mukule, your host for today. Today we are going to be talking about lights. Now, in my own understanding, I want to believe that lights play a big part in defining the mood that you exude in your house. And today I'm excited to bring to you one of the movers and shakers of the lighting industry in Uganda, so to speak. I'd love to take this chance to introduce to you to this beautiful lady from Crystal LED Euro Lights, right?
Crystal Euro LED Lighting.
All right. Thank you so much and welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Francis Mukula. What's your name, madam?
My name is Anita Litusabira. Mm-hmm. I'm the director of Crystal Euro LED Lighting, a company that designs, advises and installs lighting using the modern concept today and the quality equipment into your living spaces.
Clearly, this is very pristine and unique lighting I'm seeing here. When I look at that, I think about Europe. When I look at this, I think about Christmas. So talk to me about this particular kind of lighting. Like, what are we working with here? Just to mention them, katonoton.
First and foremost, I want people to know that we no longer light houses using a bulb and a lamp holder. Today we light houses using the different equipment that is there, and equipment that makes our homes beautiful. Actually, when you're going to buy a light, don't buy a light for light. Buy a light for beauty, and then after that you look at the light. I want people to know that we no longer buy lights for the sake of light, that it's only about light. You have to buy a light from a point of view that is beautiful. That light has to be able to save volumes when it's off. And then when it's lit, then it has to say more volume than what it was able to tell you. So we should first consider beauty, and then after beauty, we consider the output that we need out of this light.
More like the mood.
Yes, the mood.
So when your light is off, it has to exude a certain mood. And when it's on, to feel a certain vibe again.
When it's off, I don't know whether you ever noticed, when you're getting into the house, you might not be able to look at the tiles. But when you go in the house, we are looking at the lights. So we should really give ourselves those lights that are beautiful, that even when people come into our homes, they are able to admire the lights. But still then, when you switch on the light, that light should be able to tell you more volume than what it had originally told you when it was off. People should learn that the lighting has gone to another concept. Actually, when we talk about the world getting digitalized, we think that it's only in maybe phones, cars, other things, but it's also in the lighting world. In the lighting world, you can't believe somebody who is still using a lamp holder and a bulb. You're analog, but somebody who is using the lighting equipment, you're now digital. Then we also look at lighting according to the tasks that we are going to do in a space. We need to know what are the different things that we want to do in this space.
Like in the house?
Yes.
It's a kid's room.
Okay, maybe let's start with the sitting room. Are you going to be able to read? Are you going to be able to take a cup of tea, just sit there with your friends? That is the kind of lighting we look at. Are you going to watch a movie? Then we can design this home according to those different tasks. It can be a movie moment, it can be just a light moment, it can be, and those are the different concepts that we put in a living space. You can use maybe a strip light for just a moment with your
mood.
Then we can use maybe a centerpiece if we want to read. Then we can use decorative lights if you just want to take a cup of tea.
We should learn
the different
functions for the light.
Yes,
Mommy, you talked about when your light is off, it has to speak a certain vibe. When your light is on, it has to speak a certain vibe. Now, take me through what kinds of lights here, if any, just to understand which kind of lights give certain moods and which kind of light do certain things.
I'm going to ask someone to switch off this light. Okay. Have you seen it?
Yeah.
Is it telling you something? It's sparkling.
It's sparkling. Uh-huh.
You see, it's a crystal.
Uh-huh.
It is talking volumes. Now, can we switch it on?
Right.
Okay. Are you seeing it?
Yeah.
Can you imagine what is said when it was off?
Yes.
Are you imagining what it's saying now?
Yes.
Exactly.
No.
That is what.
This is my interpretation. When it was off, I felt like this is an expensive light that is installed in an expensive house. And now that I'm in, now that it's on, I feel the vibe of festivity.
And
decorative kind of stuff.
That is it. Even when you're looking at it, just imagine you're sitting in your sitting room and looking at it.
Mm-hmm.
The feeling you'll have will be different. The ideas that will be flowing into your mind will be different. The money-making ideas will come in because you'll aim at making sure that you have that light into your house. There are so many, actually. Look at this one. Just look at the decor that it makes on the ceiling. You know, those are the things that we need to look at while we are lighting our homes. It's not a matter of lighting per se. No.
Function.
Yeah, the function, but also the beauty.
The beauty.
Yes.
So let's say I have a kid room. What kind of light should I put? Should I put something that is a little bit dim, something that has, because these days there's also a mentality of, you find a single man's room has a blue light. Under his bed there's also another red light. So the thing looks like a discotheque.
Actually, the atmosphere that you would want is what you create in your living space.
Okay.
Yeah. Like for instance, the kids. For me, if I was working on a kid's room, I would first think about a colorful pendant.
Full pendant.
Colorful.
A colorful pendant.
Yes, because a kid, you make this room attractive to this kid.
So colorful pendant.
A colorful. This is a pendant, but when you look at this, it's not. Colorful. It's not. Yeah. It's not designed for a kid.
Okay.
Yeah. There are those lights that are specifically designed for kids. Then you can look at colorful strips. For instance, if it's blue, the kid will look at it as something good. The red strips, then, you know, that kind of thing. Those are the kind of things that you take into consideration. But it's very, very good that you put in mind that now I'm working for a kid. Now I'm working for a big person, an adult. So then you will be able to choose what is good for those particular people.
What are some of the mistakes in your experience that people make while choosing lighting conditions or lighting solutions?
Now, like for us, we've worked with in these homes for quite a number of times, and one of the things that people don't put into consideration is the different points. Now, someone would think that lighting comes at the end, but lighting is supposed to be to come at the beginning.
Oh.
As you're drawing your plan, you should be able to visualize the kind of lighting that you want. Now, when you come in at the end, you will have missed out the necessary points that you will need. I'll give you a scenario of mirror lights. Many people don't have mirror lights. Why? Because someone never visualized that I would have the mirror lights. But at the end of the building, you know, when you're now about to get into your house, you're putting in the lighting, and then you say, no, but I also need a mirror light. But the point was never there. So you miss out the detail.
It has to be a preset mindset.
Yes.
Exactly what you want.
What you would want. Then houses that we've gotten in and there are no wall brackets. Actually, you know, wall brackets are some of the things that add detail to your house. So if you did not put that point there, then there is no way we are going to come in and say, the first thing is we are going to tell you, break. But you know, lighting comes at the end of the tunnel and you're tired. You don't want to spend any more.
You're painted.
Exactly.
Plaster.
We are. And we are telling you, for you to get this wall bracket, you need to break. But remember that you will miss the detail if you don't put brackets. You really, in the modern world, actually, today, if you don't have wall brackets, then you have a problem.
Analog.
You're analog.
Screaming.
Yes. So it's now high time people should know. And people should differentiate between a lighting expert and an electrician. I'm telling you, you're going to use them.
A lot of us use electricians.
And they will just put the houses you go to, and there are so many spotlights, and you're like, really, how do you put all these? Really, people should learn to use their experts in the different fields. Yeah, lighting will look very beautiful as long as you do it well. But it's a matter of just using each and everybody.
In your experience, what has been some of the do you recollect any experiences, or going to a client and you find this out and like, wow, how did they even manage to put all this clutter in lighting in this house? Have you had a scenario whereby you are awestruck?
There are homes you go to, and someone has put outdoor brackets for indoor. And but remember that someone has come to you and is praising what he has done. Then you go there and then you're like, you're contemplating, because you don't also want to hurt the feelings of the client, but you're seeing that the client is using the wrong lights in the right places, you know. So some of the things that people do, and you're like, really? Did he even? But remember that he's coming to you and he's posing. Then you find these very colorful strips in the sitting room, and you're like, really?
Blue.
Yeah, but it's very hard. Sometimes we don't want to hurt the client's feelings. Maybe you try to find out how you can best tell the client, but sometimes it's very hard. That's why we recommend that please, 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 at least go. You would rather pay an extra sum, but do the right thing. And then the long-lasting things, yeah. Very many people have very, very, I don't know, you come and buy a light, and before you know it, it's rusting.
Oh, maintenance?
Not maintenance. I think it's the quality. Yeah. So people should learn how to buy. Where do you get the good things?
Actually, I would love you to speak more into the quality part of it, because there's lots of substandard goods in the market. You buy a bulb today, tomorrow it's dead. A week later, it's flickering. You know?
I've had a client who has come here, and he was looking at the outdoor light and asked me, but how am I sure that if I bought this one, it's not going to be like the ones I have?
Perception already, you know?
And I'm like, did you look at the IP when you're buying the outdoor light?
The IP.
You really need to have, when you're buying outdoor, you should know the IP that you need to buy.
What's IP?
The quality. Eh? For that quality that is able to withstand the dew, the sun, and the rain. Mm-hmm. In that, even if your light the rain came about the sun, it still remains in its state that you bought it. Yes. And those lights are there on the market. Actually, people should know that the quality things are there on the market. Much as there are so many things that are fake, but even the quality are there. The only difference with the quality, it comes with an extra cost. Yeah.
IP, let's go back to that. IP, how do I know that now I'm buying the right IP?
It's
Is it labeled?
Yeah, it's labeled. Can I get a light and I show you? Yeah. So it will either be IP65.
This is IP44.
Yes, also IP44 is IP44. Yeah. So you really need to know the IPs. From IP40 and above, it helps you this kind of light can withstand all the
outdoor conditions.
The conditions, yeah. The best one is IP65. Yeah, as long as the door is above IP40, then it will outstand the outdoor conditions. Don't just buy anyhow, because if you buy IP20 or IP25, before you know it, the color of the light has changed, it has rusted. So many things happen to your light. Yeah.
So what I take out of that is get the right information, know what you're buying, so that you don't end up buying, and know what you want to use a light for, where and how.
You know, like today, even when we are lighting our like outdoor, we have what we call decorative and we have what we call security, and the different kind of lights. But know which kind of bulb to use where.
You know,
using security, if you're looking at security, you have to use daylight bulbs. If you're using decorative, that's when you use warm light. So people need to know the different. Even now, today when someone tells you that I use a 10 watt, why would you use a 10 watt in a bedroom? Use a 2 watt.
That's too much. 10 watt is too much.
And yes, in a bedroom. Actually, in a bedroom, the maximum you should use, you should be 5 watts. But you should use a 2 watt. If you have 4 watts, those are the kind of lights, that the wattage that we should use. Yes.
So what's the biggest problem with clients? And as far as acquiring these kinds of quality products is concerned?
I think the biggest problem is first lack of information, then lack of knowing where to get these things. I wouldn't say price is a problem, maybe to a few, but I wouldn't say it is, because I don't know whether you've noticed that in today's world we live intentionally. So when you want this thing, you'll work towards getting it. Yes, because you know that it's long lasting, it's durable, it is class, it is quality. So that one I wouldn't want to say that it's a problem. But I think the biggest problem is lack of information.
Information gap. Yes. I mean, it was a pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you so much.
And I hope that with this particular episode, people now know what to do when purchasing these lights. Thank you so much. You're welcome. Guys, I hope from this particular conversation you've learned some things. For me, my takeaways are simple. One, know what you want to use a lighting for. Two, IP is very important. From IP 44 and above, those are lights that are designed for outdoor purposes. Also, watts. There's no reason you should be having a 10 watt in your bedroom. Have 2 watts. So if you don't really have the energy and time to go and find out this information or to do the research, go to the right people that will provide you the right services in the right quantities, in the right way. My name is Francis Emokule, and I hope that with this particular information, once again, you'll be able to make the right decisions. Information is key. See you here, same place, same time, here on Urban TV and Homes and Construction Show. Catch you next time.